So it's Orawan Paranang of Thailand, the team leader currently, with the serves to start it off. Well, there's definitely no panic from Orawan Paranang. Very calm there, testing out the blocking game, letting Wang Yidi take the opening attack. Changing up now to the pendulum serve. Change of pace is going to be key for Orawan Paranang. In modern history, the greatest upsets against Wang Yidi that come to mind, Hina Hayata, another left-hander from Asia. And what did Hina Hayata do? She slowed the game down. Wang Yidi's developed quite a lot at 27 years old. She's very adaptable. The never-ending point comes to an end. False advertisement, well, it was quite extended. Footwork on both sides, this camera angle, showing exactly how much was needed. And once again, the width on that ball, tested and tried, Orawan Paranang. And right back in is Wang Yidi. Still has the lead, but only by one now. Drying the hand on the table, blowing on it to keep it cool. Parallel forehand does the trick. Steps back and from behind the table, I've talked to you already this week about how physicality really determines and often indicates a style of play. You don't see choppers that are 5'2" or 155 centimeters and below. Choppers need to be tall. Orawan Paranang needs to stay as close to the table as possible, you would think. But how many points have we already seen her take from behind the table? 1 point in front here out of the towel break, Wang Yidi. Strawberry attempted the reverse spin of the Chiquita, the banana flick. A little bit of creativity with the side spin in the receive game from Paranang. A nice tight serve to the backhand. Remember, a lefty versus a righty. Serving to that backhand long can often be effective, but here a shorter serve, bringing Wang Yidi in. So five all tied up right now. As Chun Shing Tong watches, not looking super amused at the moment, her teammate in a thick score line. Incredible points. That one ball that appeared to hit the hand, I hope we get another angle. Watch this, Wang Yidi there. You can lean against the table. If you move the table, that's another story. Wow. Again, I think that ball might have caught the hand and came back with backspin, almost came over the net. Wang Yidi to reach that. She is not the tallest player on the team.
5-7.
And the fact that Orawan Paranang was then able to spin the ball to baseline and recover that swat. Really an unusual point, a treat for spectators. But out of the second towel break, it's a 2-point lead now for Wang Yidi on the receive. A quality drive to the baseline. Nothing too fancy from Wang Yidi. But this is what preparation is all about. Working hard in the training hall, so it feels like just another practice session on the table in the bright lights.
8-6.
Well played on the parallel, Paranang. Paranang's clever. Again, an up-and-coming player, it's easy to be overshadowed when you're playing in Asia. But the top player for a strong Thailand team right now. Catches the edge of the table, hence the apology from Paranang. Just one more. Sabai, it is okay. All tends to average out more or less after a match. behind the table once again, driven back. Not the choice of Paranang in the sense that Wang Yidi controlling the short game. Seven serving nine. See what we get on the serves here. Shovel it is. The flat hit kill shot to follow the long top side spin, the kicker. Beautiful combination. One in at the elbow. And as soon as Wang Yidi backs off, she's just got too much ground to cover side to side. Slower second shot and then blast the third. Pattern change from Paranang once again, and it's 9 points apiece. The third towel break here in game number one. Remember, Paranang, the best world ranking of Team Thailand, put in the third spot. This is strategy. This is the coach saying, let's surprise Team China. Sutasini and Jinipa, both very strong. But it's game point for Wang Yidi. The serve to convert as she dries the hand. Wang Yidi, second serve now. And the shovel served. You could hear that. A little bit of frustration there. Paranang knowing that she was close. Wang Yidi to serve. Waiting patiently as the net ball doesn't come down. Wang Yidi takes the first point. Heavy stomp to mask the sound and transfer weight. But it's Orawan Paranang who takes the point on receive. Wang Yidi just drying the rubber, cleaning it rather. Oh!
1-2.
I was watching to see. Sometimes you think you hear something, you start to wonder, corner to corner. She raises her hand, it seems, but says, nah, side. Close. One serving two.
Plant. 1-2.
Just because you're outside the table doesn't mean the ball hit the side necessarily. That one, though, pretty clear in the replay.
2-0.
For me, the simple standard is, if it acts like it hit a wall, it touched the side of the table. If it acts differently, then it hitting a wall, and there's any question, it must have touched the surface of the table. Wang Yidi back in front. Orawan Paranang, very tricky. Think about how many rallies we've seen so far where the pressure is high from early on. Wang Yidi gets the opening attack, drives her opponent behind the table, and still Paranang in it. Back edge of the table for Wang Yidi. So first towel break. It'll be two serving four coming out for Paranang. I like it. Both players standing probably about 7 feet from each other at that towel box. Facing each other but looking off to the distance. Eyes telling what they're thinking, planning. They say that the eyeballs look a different direction when you're recalling a memory than where they look if you're planning for the future. Fun facts for you there. Chinese fans watching on from the crowd. So keeping that 2-point lead here, back to the towel break lead. Wang Yidi with the serves on her side.
6-3.
Nice freedom here, staying loose. Wang Yidi with a bit more racket speed on that last ball than usual. What a read of serve. I couldn't read it from here. Paranang with a better view and clearly the professional. Reads what looks to be top and side spin in the replay. With the top spin on it, she closes the racket to keep it down, guides it forward. using the angles. Again, when you've got a smaller player on the other side, as soon as she takes a step back, it creates an opening on the wide wing. On the chase, behind the table, a few good punches. Makes her moves. Wang Yidi full force ahead here, right on the baseline of the table, staying there. Nice jersey. Looking fresh, Team China fans. Some dressed for prom, some dressed for the world champs here. Hey, freedom, it all goes. Oh, that shot will not come back. Wang Yidi twists and turns. Long serve to the forehand, and from the middle just guides that ball forward. Serve gets away, but that's all part of the game. Again, high risk serves. Wang Yidi has been precise only the first time I can recall this match. A gift serve. Oh man, cracking shots, spanking that one. Just goes to show you the quality of balls, that these don't have to be thrown out after being hit that hard. The best in the game. Grunt for grunt they go, and it's Paranong within two. A little smile of temporary satisfaction after 1.1. The reaction time, how high the racket is. From that camera angle, you had a clean study of Paranong. Nice textbook example of how to respond if you need to in a fast game from behind the table. But that half-long serve leaves a finger breaker. Never easy. And it is three game points for Wang Yidi to go up 2-0. Smooth backhand does it. The spinny shot, a very faint touch there as she scrapes the ball. So Sha Sha fans and the rest of the Chinese squad cheer on Team China. Top edge of the racket, would love to see it come down after that ball earlier that hit the hand and came down. A lot of people newer to table tennis wonder if the ball comes back over the net, whose point is it? And the answer is your job when you hit the ball is to hit your opponent's side. After it hits your opponent's side of the table, it's your opponent's job to touch the ball, to hit it with the racket or the hand holding the racket, and then hit your side of the table. So it's a great way to win a point if you can make the ball come back over the net against somebody who's caught in a tough position or maybe doesn't have the fastest footwork. For example, classes 1 and 2 at the Paralympics, seated players will use that shot, the tetra. Chasing for everything here, a none-dying effort. A never-give-up forehand lunge here from Paranong. Has to pull the tripod out. 3-1, Wang Yidi with a quick lead here.
1-4.
Timeout. Only need to speak a few words.
5-1.
Quality, not quantity. This is life. So shovel serve here. Low to the net, and Wang Yidi laser focus for that backhand receive. What more can you ask for? Wang Yidi has boiling heat right now, turns up the pace, and this ball disintegrates off to Barrierville after this forehand-to-forehand exchange. Tight serve as well, the most one-sided game we've seen so far. Wang Yidi saying, this is the time for me to shine. 12 of the last 16 points, Wang Yidi with serious momentum now. And a much needed point. Throwing some coal in the furnace here. The engine that is turning on for Paranong. See the engine turning on there in that moment. Nice change of pace. Paranong slowing it down a bit. Remember, Wang Yidi has no trouble with speed. the Chinese Super League is the fastest pace of play in the world. Chun Xing Tong can tell you the same, even with her hands back up in the sleeves. Good placement on this one. Paranong sends Wang Yidi on a chase to the wide forehand. Sometimes the timeout is called by Ma Lin. Stay forward, spin the ball, close the racket. You know what to do. That's the combination.
4-8.
Sun Yingxia looking over at him like, good call, coach, good call. I like it. Like, how'd you know? There's a lot of trust there, of course. Team China's dominated the game for quite some time. Parallel to finish it off, Wang Yidi recovers, and since the timeout, she converts both of her points. I talked about the domination of Team China, but being here in Korea, 1991, one of the last two times China was beaten in the women's game.
10-4.
And it was by a unified Korea, so Busan is going to be celebrating, but 1 point away from celebrating, Team China, 6 team tie points for the defending champions.
10-5.
And a gift, a Liu, for the Dui Shou, the opponent here. Shovel serve, top of the net, just barely missing that serve. She's got the wiggle room to do it, though. Second serve here, and 5 more team tie points for Wang Yidi. The receive was solid, but the follow-up even better as Wang Yidi closes the door. Orawan Paranang says, Kapwun Ka, thank you very much to the official.